In this video, we're going to look at one way to work on going around offenders and not through them in your training. My name is Coach Nick Alduro, and if you haven't done so yet, please subscribe to the channel, click the like button, and also drop a comment about a new video you would like to see next. If you're looking for extra help, check out the link in the first comment or the links in the description. We're going to really focus on one way. Now, there's other ways to do this, but this is one way on how you could really work on going around offenders in your training and not just go through them. And we're going to do that through the use of accountability and having some type of object for us to actually go around. All right, let's get to the video. This is called an inside step. So using the mat, if I was going straight at the camera, I'm gonna start with my feet a little bit skinnier, meaning narrow, not too wide, okay? And I'm gonna get into a drop. Remember, a drop is when the ball is pulled into my pocket and my feet split apart, left foot goes back, right foot goes forward. If it was the ball is my left hand, it would be the opposite. I have the cone in the middle of my body for a reason. That's gonna force me to take my inside step. So once I get into my drop, I've gotta hit those dots. I've gotta be wide enough. Why? Because being wide creates driving lines, right? Now, I can't step over the cone. I have to angle my hips down and step around the cone here. Okay, so that's called an inside step. If I were to cross this foot, that would be a cross step. But right now, I want to go right by my defender. So I'm going to use the cone and the mat to hold myself accountable. Now, if you don't have these things, that's totally fine. You could still do this. You can make this on your own. It's about 3 feet by 2 feet, and any object in the middle will do. So I get into my drop. Remember, the focus here is the inside step. My left foot has to step around the defender. Okay? We're going to do this going to the basket now, and after I go with that inside step, I'm gonna pull up. Now I got my other two cones to make sure I don't cross step. So once I take that inside step, I gotta get through there. So I'm here, I get into my drop, my opposite foot from the ball is back, my ball side foot is forward, the ball's in my pocket. I take this inside step, and I gotta get through here to take that inside step into my one dribble pull-up. Don't drop too skinny. So what do I mean by that? Don't do this and then go. You've got to be able to go from that wide stance. So once you're here, right from there, inside step. Here we go. Ball, my feet are skinny right now. Then I go wide, inside, dribble step, pull up. You can go to the basket. What you do after, it doesn't really matter. We're focused on that inside step going around the defender. Now, if I wanted to go the other way, keep the cone in the middle, take the other two objects, and again, these could be any type of objects, that you hold yourself accountable to taking that inside step. Remember, we don't want to, right now we're not working on cross stepping. Not that that's wrong. We're working on an inside step where this foot, my inside foot, doesn't pass my outside foot right here, and I'm going by the defender. But you gotta be able to go from a wide stance because that wide stance creates lines to drive, angles. So I'm gonna get into a drop, inside step, and I'm right up. Remember, we're not stepping over the middle of the cone. We've got to be able to go from wide to inside, bang, right there, and get through that little gap. Remember, you can take a layup or a shot. Right now, I'm pulling up, but the focus is the inside step.
So as you can see here, you want to make sure you have a nice wide stance because that wide stance is going to allow you to get into as straight a line as possible. And notice your hip, the inside hip, is going to be pointed down to the ground because you're clearing it and swinging it around that person or object.
Hey, if you haven't done so yet, please subscribe to the channel. Click the bell notification. You'll be notified when any of our new videos come out. And also click that like button and leave a comment. If you're looking for extra help, check out the link in the first comment or the links in the description.